Hey, hi everyone, this is Mukesh Otwani once again from learn-automation.com. Today in this video, we are going to talk about how we can read images in Java using OCR. Okay, so let's get started and let's talk about what exactly we are going to cover in this video. So first of all, we are going to talk about one new term called Tesseract. Okay, so this is the exact OCR engine which is going to help us for reading the images. Then we'll talk about that Tess4j, what exactly is Tess4j, and how we can use the same library in our Maven projects, and how we can start reading the data. Now, when I say start reading the data, we are going to talk about how we can read images, because we have seen in the previous videos how to read Excel files, how to read XML files, JSON files, but how to read images and why we need images, that we will talk in the next video. So in order to read images, you also have to train your system that whenever you get this kind of images, it will be converting into this character, right? So we have to download some set of data that I will show you how to download, from where to download, where to keep everything. And finally, we'll take some random images and we'll start reading it. So what exactly is Tesseract OCR? So it's an optical character recognition engine, okay, for different operating system. It's completely free. It comes under Apache license. So what exactly it will do? It will help us to read images. Okay, OCR stands for optical character recognition. Now, Tess4j is a separate Java wrapper on this API. Okay, so you don't have to go in depth about Tesseract OCR API. In case if you're interested, definitely you should read about it. I have given the link in the previous slide. Just go through it. They have given some in-depth how exactly they read images. So Tess4j is the main library that we have to focus. This is the main library which we will add in our Maven project, and we'll start using all the methods which is present under Tess4j. Believe me, guys, it is just two lines of code that you need to write and you can read images. Previously, it was not that stable, but they have gone through a couple of iteration, and now they come to a stage where you can see, you will see the accuracy up to 90%. I will not say 100% because still few characters it is not able to recognize, but up to 90% you can see the accuracy. So these are few links which I have already listed here. So I will show you these links. So this is the official link for Tesseract OCR. All they have given, all the GitHub links here, you can just visit it once. Now the next slide, or the next site which you have to focus, is Tess4j source fork.net. Here they have given all the usage, code, sample, documentation, everything, and you can see they have also given the Maven central repository, right? So if you click here, it will start directly this Maven repository, and you can directly start using these dependencies. You can see the first version which they have released in 2014. Now it has been 5 years and they have done so much changes, and now it comes to a stable stage. So you can start using it. I will show you in the demo how you can use it. If you have time, just go through a couple of code examples which they have given, the documentation, everything. Okay, so this is how they're telling us to read it. So if you just go to code samples, you'll find that you need just one line of code. Okay, and finally you need to call one method called doOCR. Okay, that's all. It will return you everything as a string. So let me do the same thing. Let me check what else. Yeah, so dependency and the train data. So if you go to this test data, okay, you will find different trained data for different languages. Okay, so you can see they have almost for every language they have a trained data. What we will do, we'll focus on English. So we will download this data, okay, and that we will be using in our program. But you can see they have the different trained data for different languages. So just download based on your requirement and you can start using it. Okay, so very easy, just download this trained data and download the dependency, and that's all. Okay, just go through this site. It is very easy, and hardly it will take 30 minutes to go through the complete documentation as well. So let me go back to my Eclipse. So this is my Eclipse, and let me create a separate class. Let's create a package and I will say OCR demo. And let me quickly create a class and I will say read images public static void main. Okay, now first step which is required, that you need to change your poem.xml. When you say poem.xml, just open this section and you can see I already have added here. In case if you have not added, what you can do, just go back here, select any version. The one I was using is 4.2.1. okay, so you can also go with 4.2.1, which I found latest stable, because you can see in the latest one 4.3.1 I did not find much usage. So this was the highest usage which I found and it is working as expected. So I would recommend you to go ahead with 4.2.1, but in case if you want to try with 4.3.1 also, you just go ahead and try. If that doesn't work, you can degrade it. Anyways, just a single change you have to do here. Apart from that, what you need to do, you need to create a folder called test data and you need to keep your train data here. Sometime if you keep in the project working directory, it doesn't work. So always suggested, if you go to their official documentation, they have suggested that you need to create a folder called test data and you need to download the train data from the site and you need to keep in this particular folder. That's all. Okay, so we have downloaded English train data and we kept under test data. That's all. Poem dependency is done. Train data is already downloaded. In case if you are not sure how to download, okay, let's say this is the one which you want to download, English train data. Just click here and you can see this download option. Just download this, keep under that particular folder, and that's all. Okay, the images which I want to read, I will show you two images. Okay, one is very basic image, one is little tricky. So this is the basic image which we want to read. So it's something, it's not about perfect and some good code. Another image which we will read is something like this, and it has something text, then special characters, and then some again captcha. So the main reason why I'm showing you this site, because after this particular video I will show you how you can read images based captchas. Okay, so let's say you want to log into IRCTC and this is the text which you are getting, right? Type in the box below, and this is the captcha which you have to enter here, which is 6KIE. So in the next demo I will show you how you can capture this captcha, first of all read it and process it via OCR, and finally do the send keys and continue sign in. So whenever you have this kind of captchas, we will be able to automate via, or we will be able to capture via Tesseract OCR engine. So that is our next task. But in order to do this, first see how we can read the images. So the first line which you have to remember is one interface called iTesseract. Okay, you can see it's a separate interface. All the common OCR methods are predefined in this interface. So we will create one reference, and we have another class called Tesseract. So this is the main class, guys, which implements all the method of iTesseract interface. Okay, so iTesseract, that's all. Now if you just go through this class, you will find all the methods which they have implemented. Okay, just go through it, you will find everything which is implemented. So all the method which is coming from interface, this class has implemented. You can see this do OCR. We have multiple methods for do OCR. So in case if you have time, just go through it, in case if you're interested to know what is happening inside. Otherwise you can directly start calling the method. The method name which we have is do OCR. OCR again, optical character recognition, and it is asking you give me the file, that's all. So you can see it will perform the OCR operations on that particular image, and what it returns a string. So You can see it is asking the image file in file format. So we have to provide as a file format, and I have to provide the location. So the location part, I will go here and I will just do shift right click, copy as path, and I will just paste here. Okay, some additional characters are coming. Let me just remove this. That's all. Now it is throwing you some checked exception called tesseract exception. You can handle it via try catch. In case something goes wrong, it will come to catch block and we will see. So let me quickly check. I will say exception details e dot get message. Exception. Plus e dot get message. Now, as we have seen, it will return you string, right? So I will store in a str, and now let's print this and let's see what exactly it returns. So I will put like data from image is plus str. That's all. So just right click. Okay, something is getting downloaded. Okay, it's something from, I guess, testing. So let it happen in the background. Let's run our test as Java application. And it is failing. It says null at line number 18. Okay, it means something goes wrong here. It is not able to identify the path. Okay, whenever you see null, it is clearly something is wrong with the file extension or with the file path. So guys, I quickly checked and I found in their official documentation they have clearly mentioned as of now this supports JPG, GIF, PNG, BMP and other format. The file which we have currently, it was a JPG file, okay, so which was not supported. So what I did, I created a PNG file, same file I just edited and I converted into PNG file. You can also convert into PNG, JPEG or TIFF format and then you can start reading it. So as of now, one thing we got to know, JPG is not supported, JPEG is supported, okay? So in case if you have that image, you can convert it and then you read it. So now let's do that. What we have another file called Mukesh file 1 and that I converted into PNG, okay? I did not follow the documentation that it does not support JPG, but as per the documentation we'll go with PNG file. And now without modifying the code, let's run the same thing. Okay, you can see it is giving us the data and just cross verify. Okay, it says it's not about perfect, it's about effort. When you bring that effort every single day, that's where the transformation happens, right? So we are able to see the data. That's perfect. Now the next task, we need to see how we can read captchas, right? So in order to do that, what I will do, I will first of all create another file and I will simply change the path. So this is the captcha which we want to read, right? So this is, I guess, PNG if I'm not wrong. So let me just do the check property. Yeah, it's PNG file and name is captcha.png. So path is exactly same, guys. So I will just change the captcha.png and now let's run it and let's see how it behaves. Okay, awesome. We're able to capture the captcha as well, right? So this is the captcha which we need to capture and we need to enter. So now my question is, how do we extract only the captcha part? Because it is giving the complete string, right? Now my question is how we can extract this. So what we can do, we can write a small regular expression, okay, which will simply extract all the digits, sorry, all the captcha code which is coming. Okay, perfect. So let's do this. Now, for this, what we will do, we'll split the string first of all, and I will show you how to split. Now, one thing which you have to notice here, our captcha is coming after this keyword below, right? So I will split the string into two parts. So this will be my first half, and this will be our second half. So we will focus on the second half and we'll write a regular expression in a such a way that it should give me only the characters, not the spaces, not the special characters, not anything, only the characters, whether it's a small, capital, right? So let's split the string whenever we find below. So I will say str dot below, first of all, split. Now definitely it will return you a string array, right? So I will store this in a string array, let's say my array. Now we definitely need the second part, right? Because in the second part we have the data. I will say arr, my arr 1. And what I need to replace all the characters which is unnecessary with a blank, right? So you can see I have a method called replace all. Here I just need to give the regular expression and what you want to replace, right? So we'll write a regular expression and replacement we need blank. We don't need anything. You want to just remove it. Okay, so if you give a space, it will replace with a space, but we'd want to remove it directly. So I have not given anything, it is just double quote. Now, what to replace, right? Like first it has to found the pattern, then it has to replace. So here we will give a regular expression, that bracket, and we'll say A to Z all the characters in small letters and capital letters. So whenever you find capital A to Z or small A to Z, replace them with blank. Okay, let's see what it returns. So definitely it will return the opposite result which we are not expecting. So I will say my data. And if you want to print, let's print that, because anyways we are going to deal with my arr 1, right? So let me just print this so that you can understand what exactly this data will return. And if you want, let's put in a debug mode. Yes, it is very interesting. So let's split. Okay, whenever we do a split, you can see we have two, first half and second half. So this is what we need, second half, which is second part, which is colon, then what is special character, then spaces and all, right? Now what we are telling that inside this, replace all the special, like replace all the characters with blank. So definitely it will find all these characters, right? And it will replace with blank. So you can see the last data is nothing but only the colon and dot, right? But what we need is opposite, that we don't need any other thing, we just need letters, right? So you can use another symbol, okay? So for this, what you can do, we can give caret condition. What it will do, it will ask, it will instruct this particular method that accept A to Z, which is small and capital, replace everything with blank. So it is totally opposite. It says whenever you find capital A to Z, small A to Z, do not do anything. Apart from that, anything which you find, okay, replace them with blank. Now if you right click and run as, you can see we got the data. This is the data which we need, which we can enter. So now I don't have to print anything. I will just remove everything. This was just for our understanding. Our end goal is that I need my capture code. So guys, if you're completely new to regular expressions, then don't worry, I will make a separate video on that because it's a very interesting part, and with the help of regular expressions you can avoid a lengthy code. Okay, if you don't write this regular expression, again you need to split the string whenever you find colon, then again when you find a space, again a split. So in spite of doing all that, you just need to write a small regular expression and your task can be done in a single line. Okay, so this is what we have done. In the next video, we will capture the captcha image at runtime, read it and enter it. Okay, for regular expressions, okay, this is the regular expression which you can use for this particular captcha. In case if you find some different kind of captchas, then you need to write different regular expression. Okay, so I hope it is clear. Just two lines of code. This is one interface, one class, call this method, that's all. One thing, it does not support JPG format. Once you get the data, you can formulate or you can change based on a requirement, right? So that's all I have from this video. So in case if you have any other question, you can let me know in the comment section. If you still have any questions apart from this, you can send me as an email to my email ID, which is mukesh.one@learn-automation.com. And if you like this video, please share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will see you in the next video. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.